Welcome to Department of Electronics and Telecommunication at Vidya Alankar Institute of Technology. In this department, we have taken this new initiative to start our own YouTube channel. In this YouTube channel, we are going to upload all our experiments video, value-added course video, or any other important videos. This material will be available to all the students in Mumbai University, and this material will help students to enhance their learning, not just in their classroom, but even outside the classroom. I hope that everyone will like this our effort, and in case of any query, comments, anything, they can put it in comment box. Thank you.
Hello everyone, welcome to Communication Engineering Laboratory 1. This is experiment number 4, titled To Study Quadrature Amplitude Modulation. Our objective is to make the students understand about the quadrature amplitude modulated signal. So in QAM we have two modulated signals. Both of them are ASK modulated first, and among them both, one of them is phase shifted by 90 degree. Because there is a phase shift of 90 degree, this is known as quadrature amplitude modulation. Let's look into the program now. Let's go to file, new, script. So now we are done with the typing of the program. Let's check the program step by step. CLC is used to clear all the text in the command window. Clear all is used to clear all the objects in the workspace of MATLAB. Close all is used to close all the unwanted figure windows. First we define the FC, that is carrier frequency, which we take approximately 10,000 Hz. Then next two modulating frequencies are defined, because we need two modulating signals, that is these two, in QAM. Next we define the time interval, that is time starts from this figure and it increments up to this figure and terminates at this 1 by FM2, that is 1 by 100. Next we define the modulating signals and the carrier signal. Next we define the modulated signals X1 and X2. If X1 is sine, then X2 needs to be cos, that is because there is a 90 degree, we need to take a 90 degree phase shift in QAM. Next, the addition of these two signals, that is X1 and X2, is stored in SQAM. Next, we plot. We plot T versus SQAM. We give title, quadrature amplitude modulation for this all these frequencies. And then we give the X label and Y label and grid on. Grid on is used for dividing the given figure into grids. Now let's check the output. This is the output we obtained for QAM signal. Thanks for watching.